Cat had been unusually quiet as of late, Xander thought. She strode into the bedroom in a cotton tank and pajama shorts, and he was already in bed waiting for her. Molly, her Labrador hearing dog, was at the foot of the bed, and Sadie, her rescued shepherd cross, was on the floor on a big dog bed. Flea, the speckled gray Great Dane she'd also rescued, was curled up with Sadie, and all the dogs were watching her. She ran her hand over each of them and signed good night. It was just something she did, no matter how ridiculous it looked to him. They were her dogs, her support, her safety, her everything, and she depended on them as much as they did on her. The bond between them was both deep and strong and unbreakable. When she sat, he tapped her shoulder, even though she still had her component attached behind her ear. She flicked her eyes his way, the odd shade of blue that was always filled with such mystery.
"You need to do something about Molly," he said. "She can join her sisters on the floor."
She just smiled as she shook her head and then patted the bed, a gesture for Molly to come closer, which she did, scooting up to sit with her paws forward, wagging her tail, which flicked against Xander's leg. "She's been sleeping with me since you got her for me, and I like having her here," Cat said, nuzzling Molly's face with hers. She kissed her head. "You're such a good girl," she said in that baby talk way. Yeah, she loved her dogs. And so did he, considering they were her ears and kept her safe from everything, the streets, the people. Only now Molly was between him and her on their bed.
"She's a dog," Xander said. "She can go to our feet, or better yet, the floor."
He gestured to Molly, snapping his finger and pointing, but she was having none of it from him as she merely looked from him to Cat. He couldn't remember when it was that she'd started listening to Cat over him.
"Traitor,"
he added. He took in Cat's smirk, but she nonetheless clapped her hands and gestured to the foot of the bed. Molly moved, and Cat slid into bed beside him and pulled the clip from her honey gold hair, letting it fall to her shoulders. She leaned in and pressed a kiss to his lips, then went to reach around to take her component off from behind her ear, but he reached out and slid his hand over her wrist to stop her.
"Hey,"
he said.
"You haven't said anything about your brother and Angie. Michael invited us up to one of his games to stay for the weekend, but you didn't say anything. I told him today we'd get back to him. I think he wants you to meet Angie."
Cat hadn't said a word to him about the invite since Michael had called that afternoon. When he'd asked, she'd only pulled in a breath as if considering something and then walked away. It had been the same since she'd learned what Michael had done, having a drunken birthday celebration in Vegas and waking up married. "I didn't think you liked Michael," she said. "But now you're conversing with him like you two are best buds or something." Okay, maybe he'd been a little too vocal on his opinion of her brother, who had always given him the impression of someone who'd had things way too easy. His privileged childhood with a family of means, his career in the pros, and now his carefree lifestyle in the league.
"I helped him out because he's family," Xander said. "But I never said I didn't like Michael. He's your brother. I just think he expects to have everything handed to him and hasn't had to work as hard as everyone else out there. He gets himself in trouble, and..."
"And you think he deserved what happened to him? His drunken marriage?" Cat cut him off. He wasn't sure what to make of her remark or the way she was staring at him now. The Michael and Cat relationship was a minefield that he wasn't sure how to traverse. It was tricky and filled with far too many unexpected triggers.
"Well, he's still married to her, and you've yet to meet her. I didn't say he deserved it. I said that he screwed up big time, and he did. The drinking, the parties, the girls. He's far from a saint, and yeah, in my opinion, he was irresponsible. But then..."